अस्तो मा अस्तो मा सद्गमया तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमया मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमया। योर टर्न। ओम अस्तो मा सद्गमया तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमया मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमया। ओम अस्तो मा सद्गमया
सद्गमय
तमसो मा
सोमा
ज्योतिर्गमया
ज्योतिर्गमय
मृत्योर्मा अमृतं
अमृतम
गमया। ओम अस्तो मा सद्गमया तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमया
ज्योतिर्गमय
मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमया। ओम अस्तो मा सद्गमया तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमया मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमया। ओम अस्तो मा सद्गमया तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमया मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमया।
अरविंद
नाभा शुक्ला जी प्लीज स्टार्ट करते हैं।
जी, यहाँ जो सभी लोग बैठे हुए हैं, पहले मैं उनसे एक निवेदन कर लूं कि आप लोग कुछ योगासन भी देखेंगे और आप साथ साथ चाहे तो योगासन कर भी सकते हैं। उसके लिए अपने योगा मैट साथ तैयार रखिए, और अगर आप जमीन पर नहीं बैठ पाते तो आप जहां बैठे हैं वहां बैठे हुए अपने आसन कर सकते हैं। तो गुड आफ्टरनून लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, एज यू आर अवेयर द इकफा यूनिवर्सिटी देहरादून वॉज एस्टेब्लिश्ड अंडर द यूनिवर्सिटी एक्ट 2003 ऑन July 8, 2003। आई एम ग्लैड टू शेयर दैट द यूनिवर्सिटी इज रैंक्ड 46th अमंग ऑल इंडियन यूनिवर्सिटीज एंड फर्स्ट अमंग प्राइवेट यूनिवर्सिटीज ऑफ उत्तराखंड इन 2021। द इकफा एजुकेशन स्कूल, a part of Iqfa University Dehradun, was established in 2006 to promote quality education, research, training and consultation with a global perspective. On behalf of Iqfa University and Iqfa Education School, I, Arvind Nab Shukla, would like to invite you today to celebrate International Yog Divas 2021. योग एक प्राचीन शारीरिक, मानसिक और आध्यात्मिक अभ्यास है जिसकी उत्पत्ति भारत में हुई थी। योग शब्द की व्युत्पत्ति संस्कृत की युज धातु से हुई, जिसका अर्थ है जुड़ना। महर्षि पतंजलि के अनुसार योगश्चित्त वृत्ति निरोधः, यानी चित्त की वृत्तियों को रोकना ही योग है, या युज्यते असौ योगः, अर्थात जो जोड़े वह योग है। यह जुड़ाव शरीर और चेतना का भी हो सकता है, आत्मा और परमात्मा का भी। वहीं गीता में कुछ अलग संदर्भ में योगः कर्मसु कौशलम कहा गया, जिसका अर्थ है कि कर्म में कुशलता ही योग है। योग दुनिया में विभिन्न रूपों में प्रचलित है और लोकप्रियता में लगातार बढ़ रहा है। इसी सार्वभौमिक स्वीकार्यता को सम्मान देते हुए संयुक्त राष्ट्र ने 11 दिसंबर 2014 के दिन रेजोल्यूशन 69/131 द्वारा 21 जून को अंतरराष्ट्रीय योग दिवस के रूप में घोषित किया। संयुक्त राष्ट्र के अनुसार अंतरराष्ट्रीय योग दिवस का उद्देश्य योग का अभ्यास करने के अनेकानेक लाभों के बारे में दुनिया भर में जागरूकता को बढ़ाना है। लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, वी सेलिब्रेट इंटरनेशनल योग दिवस 2021 एट ए टाइम वेन COVID-19 पैंडेमिक continues to topple lives and livelihoods of people globally. Beyond its immediate impact on physical health, the COVID-19 pandemic has also aggravated the psychological suffering and mental health problems, including depression and anxiety. This has highlighted the urgent need to address the mental health dimension of the pandemic in addition to the physical health aspect. That leads to the theme which has been selected for today's talk, building immune system and stress management. Before I move on, I would like to introduce Dr. Mudhu Vinay, Honorable Vice Chancellor of the ICFAI University, Dehradun, and a certified academic leader by Center of Academic Leadership and Educational Management, MHRD. He has around 3 decades of rich experience in field of education, training, planning, management, and consultancy. He is recognized not only for establishing institutions, but also leading them to excellence in academic and research with his path-breaking initiatives. He has been conferred the Vice Chancellor of the Year Award in the year 2020 by Uttarakhand State Council for Science and Technology, Government of Uttarakhand. Thank you very much, sir, for being present here. Sir, I would now request you to address the gathering.
So, good morning to all the participants, and my special thanks to today's Yogarushi Vishwaketu, who is the Himalayan yoga master and founder of Akananda Yoga, choosing the topic building human system and stress management. On behalf of ICFAI University, Dehradun, I welcome Guruji for today's session on this auspicious day, which is set up by the present government. I think we should appreciate Prime Minister Modi, who had initiated this International Yoga Day on 21st June. I once again welcome Yogarishi Vishwaketu to start the session, please. Back to Arvind, please.
Thank you, sir, for your guidance and support to all of us. Devi aur Sajjano, Bharat Bhumi, Darveshon, Fakiron, Sadhuon, Tapasviyon, Mahatmaon, Siddhon, Rishiyon aur Yogiyon ki Bhumi rahi. जिन्होंने हजारों वर्षों तक भारतीय प्राच्य विद्या को न केवल संचित किया, न केवल विकसित किया, बल्कि उस ज्ञान को निरंतर अगली पीढ़ियों के लिए आगे भी बढ़ाया। हमारे लिए बड़े सम्मान का विषय है कि एक ऐसे ही मनीषी, एक ऐसे ही योगी आज हमारे बीच उपस्थित हैं, जिन्हें पूरा संसार योगर्षि विश्वकेतु के रूप में जानता है। लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इट्स एन ऑनर टू इंट्रोड्यूस यू टू टुडेज कीनोट स्पीकर and chief guest, respected Yogarshi Vishwaketu. Yogarshi Vishwaketu has MA and PhD in Yoga Philosophy at Gurukul Kangri, the University of Haridwar. Yogarshi Vishwaketu, or commonly known as Vishwaji, is an internationally renowned author, conference presenter, and yoga teacher trainer. Practicing over 40 years, Yogarshi Vishwaketu is the author of Yogasana, the Encyclopedia of Yoga Poses, and collaborated on the Business Casual Yogi. For those who are interested, both the books are available on Amazon. After many years teaching internationally, Vishwaji co-founded Anand Prakash Yoga Ashram Trust in Tapovan, Rishikesh on Deepavali 2007. The ashram has become a gathering place for Akhanda Yoga family. One may join him at Akhanda Yoga Online for a full array of classes and wisdom talks. Respected Yogarshi Vishwaji, may I now invite you to enlighten the gathering on today's topic, building immune system and stress management. Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much. Let's sitting into any easy, comfortable pose. Hands to your knees. touch index finger with your thumb. Softly close your eyes. Relax your five senses. Relax your nerves. A little more relax your face. Calm your mind. Slowly pay attention to your breathing and make your breath slowly longer, exhale, and slowly longer, inhale. Big inhaling, big exhaling. While you are doing this practice, just focus on third eye, middle of the forehead. Give a gentle smile. Just bring palms in Namaskar Mudra. We're going to chant three Om together. Big happy inhale. Om. Inhale. Slowly rubbing your palms. And keep your palms on your eyes. Feel warmness of your palm. Feel internal calm and relax. Gently remove your palms. Big smile. Namaste to your neighbors, even yet they are virtual. Namaste, namaste. Just namaste to your virtual neighbors. So today I'm very happy and to be honored to be part of this university, to journey, to be there, to sharing this yoga practice with you. I will give slightly introduction about myself. I live in Rishikesh. Sometime here, sometime in Canada or UK or US or Italy or Australia. Per year I travel at least maybe 6 or 7 countries, about 200,000 kilometers per year I travel to share this yoga to people. Yoga has been part of my life since my childhood, and when my education is start from the Gurukul, when I was 8 years old, so I went into the Gurukul Karmashram, where is the name of the Bharat, Karma Rishi Ashram. After that, I went to the 5-year degree in the Hisar Sports College. So yoga and sports, how this yoga work with the sports journey. After that, I did my master degree in yoga in Gurukul Kangdi, Haridwar, and also I did my PhD from the Gurukul Kangdi. I did my PhD in 2001. And now, since then, I have been traveling and teaching and sharing this beautiful blessing we received from our ancestors to thousands and people around the world. So also I trained teachers how to be practiced and how to share this wisdom. I have over 4,000 yoga teachers around the world. So for this time, usually I am in Canada or somewhere else, but this time I am very happy to be in India. And when is this International Yoga Day? It was just my so lucky to be here and to connecting to you guys. So Akhandi Yoga or Yoga is not something you do physical thing. This first we need to understand slightly or briefly what is this physical body. When we understand this physical body, then you understand what is running. Then who is running? These are the very simple things. First, need to aware this physical body made by five elements: earth, water, air, ether, fire. So these are the five elements, and these five elements are the nature. So when you do yoga practice, then actually you are communicating to the nature. In Ayurveda, there is a three things, vata, pitta, kapha. They made by five elements. When these five elements are imbalanced in this body, then we start to feel sickness and blockage and all kind of things. We start to feel weak, or our immune system get weaker. If this is five elements is not balanced. So what yoga practice does, first thing is to balance your five elements, Panch Mahabhut. And Panch Mahabhut is communicate to the universe. So this body directly is communicating to the universe. Second thing to understand this physical body, you are not owner of this body. The owner of this physical body is the nature. We are only here user. If you use in the right way, this body give you so many blessing. It with this body you can do many things in this lifetime. But if you are not taking the responsible and respect this body with these five elements, these five elements will start to become a blockage in your journey. That's very simple. Second thing to understand, this physical body is you receive these five elements from your ancestor, from your parents. And we have lots of information planned from our ancestor from in our DNA. So yoga practice is really very powerful tool to reprogramming your DNA every day. When you do yoga practice, means you reprogramming yourself every day. Next thing is to build the immune system, we need to know the few things. One thing is our sleeping cycle. These are the four things. Our sleeping cycle, it have to be balanced. If his sleeping cycle is okay, your serotonin and melatonin hormones is works better. Sympathetic, parasympathetic nerve system is work better. Second one is your breathing cycle. Your breathing cycle is really help to calm your nerve system. That is, medical science has proved, there is so many research are available, and yogis has been talking to about it from thousands of years. Sympathetic and parasympathetic nerve system is calmed by your breathing. Your high blood pressure and all of those things can be calmed with your breathing. Third one is your digestion. Digestion is important. If your digestion is a right way, is working and processing properly, so your immune system is much, much better. It supports you. Fourth one is the detoxification. Detoxification, going through the bathroom, going through the eyes, ear, skin, nails, they all have to be detoxification system. So our four system, if it's working well, smoothly each other, so your immune system, it build itself. And when is immune system is built, you healing your whole body in whole way. It's not something you fix, it's just diabetes. In yoga, we say if you do something, you do for everything. It will improve your lungs, improve your respiratory system, it improve your blood circulation, it improve your kidneys, liver, digestion, detoxification, it improve your sleeping cycle. It is improve everything. Is not just one thing. Can people keep talking, one thing can improve and this and that. No, yoga work into the whole way. Because this body is made by five elements. Five elements is not just one thing. When do yoga, it means you are working into the whole system, whole existence. That's the meaning of the yoga. Melting with the universe, and universe is melting into you. Union, sinking into the universe, sinking with the energy, sinking with the space. So that's the meaning of the yoga. So these are the four things. Your sleeping cycle, breathing cycle, digestion, and detoxification. These are the four things is important to improve, that improve your immune system. And yoga does really well for that one. So let's I will keep talking and doing things and explaining things. So first we will start Gayatri Kriya. Gayatri Kriya have the few breathing techniques and few movement for that one is really, really helpful and simple, and everybody can do it. It improve the health of your immune system. It improve the health of your spine. It improve the health of your gland system. It improve the health of your sleeping and neurological system. So let's we will begin with the Gayatri Kriya. First thing is purification, letting go of something. Letting go of fear, anger, frustration, anxiety is exhaling. Is it start looks like that? We call Kapalbhati. Kapalbhati, when you exhale, your belly goes in. Exhaling happening until your pelvis, until Muladhara Chakra. Inhaling is very slow, passive. Exhaling actively, so then you can make a all carbon dioxide is out from your system. And when carbon dioxide out from your system, your parasympathetic nerve system is start active. Your vagus nerve is start to active when is carbon dioxide oxide is out from your system. In yogic term, we call apan pran. Okay, let's we will start. Exhale. Happy inhale. If someone has moon cycle, please go slowly. Exhale. Keep going, keep going. Few more rounds. Exhale a little bit more longer until Muladhara Chakra. Last three. One, two, three. Exhale. A little bit more exhale and hold breath out. Holding breath out, back straight, eyes closed, and just feel lots of tingling sensation happening all over on your body. Just 5 more seconds, hold breath out. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now happy inhale with a smile. Big inhale. Expand your lungs into 360 degree. Hold breath in for a moment and just feel you are sending this pranic life force to every cells of your body. You're recharging them. You are activating your immune system. Exhale all the way empty, slowly happy inhale, long inhale in your entire body. Exhaling. One more time, inhale. Exhaling. Beautiful. Let's soften your breath. Meditate on your third eye for a moment and just feel internal awakening that build your willpower, confidence. When you're connecting to your soul and soul is guiding you, you are charged with divine force. You're charged with this universal energy. Now let's softly open your eyes. Come into that table pose. We are doing Marjari Asana, cat pose. Bring your knees below your hips, wrist and shoulder in one line, pointing toes back. And please follow my instruction. Marjari Asana is so good for your spine and is excellent for your glands, especially on thyroid, parathyroid gland. Let's all together exhale. Inhale, raise your head. Navel down, tailbone up, looking up. Now exhaling, bring head down, touch the chin to the throat, belly in, tuck tailbone in. Inhale, raise your head, navel down, tailbone up. Exhaling, bring your head down, round your back, tuck tailbone in. Three more times together. Inhale, raise your head, navel down, tailbone up. Exhaling, bring your head down, round your back, tuck tailbone in. Second last, happier. Inhale, raise your head, looking up, navel down. Exhaling, bring head down, round your back. Empty, empty, empty. Next, inhale, look forward. Exhale, cross your ankle and let's sit down into easy pose for spinal twisting. So our spine have to move into all direction every day. There is no way you can make your spine healthier. If your spine is healthy, you are young. You are happy, your neurological system is working well. So you just work on the spine back and forth in all 33 vertebrae. Now we are working on that twisting. Follow my instruction. Inhale, raise arms up. As you exhale, you twist your right side, bring hands down, hold your right knee with left hand, long arm, right hand on the ground, looking back over right shoulder. Aankhe band, gehre lambe swaans. Big inhale, big exhale. And just feel your spine is breathing. Make your spine to breathe. Yeah, looking over right shoulder. Make your exhale a little bit longer. Allow to breathe your spine. If your spine breathing every day, you are young. All disease, all kind of problem is gone. Not only that, you are activating your Ida, Pingala and Susmana nadis. One more breath here. Next inhale, raise your arms up. Create extension, make your spine long. Exhale, twisting left side. Hold your left knee with your right hand. Keep left palm on the ground, looking back over left shoulder. Eyes closed. Deep inhale, deep exhale. Little bit extra exhale and just feel how your spine is breathing. One more breath here. Next, inhale. Raise your arms up. Lift. And exhaling, bring hands down. So you work on that twisting now. We are working on the sideway. So for this one, keep right palm on the ground like this. Or you can walk your right palm, right side, and right elbow on the ground. If your body allow you, always just be careful what's your body allow you. Now press left knee down. So this part of the your side, left side is opening. So now you're opening your lung, one lung at a time, and definitely working on your spine. Raise left hand up, touch index finger with your thumb. You can just hold air or bring left hand right side and slightly looking up, pressing left knee down, holding pose here, deep breathing, deep inhale, deep exhale, and just feel your left lung is opening. Your left lung, there is a heart. Just feel you directly breathing in and out in your left side of lung, and you are activating your Ida Nadi called lunar energy. Lunar energy is responsible for your creativity. Lunar energy is responsible for sense of the pleasure. Lunar energy is responsible for loving, kind. Now, next inhale, let's slowly come up. Lift, exhale, left palm on the ground. Just here, or please you do same variation what you did from other side. Keep right hand up, or bring right hand, left side, keep right knee, pressing right knee down. So your right lung is opening, and breathe deeper. Make your exhale a little longer so there is more space for inhalation. So only oxygen, you can increase oxygen in your body when you can make exhale longer. If you keep inhaling and your exhale is not longer, there is no way anyone can increase the oxygen in the body. Exhale, making the carbon dioxide from your body is very simple, but half of things is people talking nonsense stuff. Just inhale, inhale, you increase your oxygen. No, first we have to exhale to increase the oxygen, make the space in your system. Just few more breath here. Make your exhale longer. Bigger, happier inhale. One more time, exhale longer. Big inhale. Next, inhale, slowly come into center. Raise arms up. And exhale, bring hands down. So we did the spinal into the all four direction, back and forth, twisting sideways. So now we are going to do strengthening and strengthening our abs and back muscles. That is very important for our daily life to have those things to preventing back issues, knee issues, hips issues, and neck issues. So let's do that. Slightly, let's stretch your legs forward. Open your legs a little bit. Flex your feet, interlock your fingers. So we are going back and forth. I am quickly demonstrating and telling what's the common mistake people make here. When we go back here, people round back this. Is not rounding back, we're lifting chest here, keeping belly in, active thighs. Now exhale, going forward is as far as your body allows you. But if your hamstring is quite tight, you can put pillows underneath of your sitting bone. So that's really help if you have tight hamstring. Active thighs, and these are the common mistakes people make. Let's start. Interlock your fingers, arms straight, all together, inhale, and going back. Exhaling forward. Inhaling, going back. Lift your chest. Exhaling forward. Inhaling, going back and lift. Active thighs. Exhale forward. Two more times. Inhale. A little bit more, going back. Exhale forward. Inhale, going back. Exhale forward. This time, let's hold big toes or feet or ankle, whatever is available for you. And let's bring head down. Shoulders back. Relax your shoulders. You stay in the pose. Follow my instruction. Just feel between shoulder blades. Make your exhale a little longer. Inhale between shoulder blades. That's where is the biggest part of the lungs is more active and open. Exhale longer. Inhale between shoulder blades. Your body will be more oxygenated, and I call also is prana knitting. Just breathing. One more breath. Next inhale, let's slowly come up, raise your head. This time we're making a circle. So when you're making a circle, many group of muscles are used in this one. So first one, what we just did, we're going back and forth. You're strengthening abdominal muscles, toning them, and back muscles. Now, to maintain good health of our spine, we need our side muscles too. So we're doing the circle. So in that way, maximum muscles group you are using in your body. Okay, so let's start. Interlock your fingers, flex your feet, big inhale. Exhaling forward, inhaling your right side. Going back and up, exhaling, going left side, make a circle, keep belly in. गहरे लंबे श्वास, पेट को अंदर रखिए, दोनों पैर बिल्कुल सीधे, वन मोर राउंड. Let's switch direction, left to right. And just feel different muscles group you are using. Your breath and movement is sinking. Two more times. Last one. Very good. Let's come into center. Release. How is everyone is doing? You can say something. Everybody is okay? Okay. So next one we are doing Parvati Asana. In this one, you could put the feet together and bring to close to you. 50% lower back issue comes from the tighten our hip muscles and hip joints. And this pose is really good to release the tension from the hip joints, also is release the tension from the lower back. Now let's inhale. Exhaling, slowly coming forward. Maybe just elbows on the ground, or palms on the ground, or elbows on the ground, or forehead on the ground. Just feel wherever your body allow you and breathe deeper. That's the key here. That's the mantra of the yoga, is the breathe deep, slowly, with observe, with consciously. Next inhale, slowly coming up. Exhale. Now let's sitting into any easy pose. Simple pose or Ardha Padmasana or Padmasana, whatsoever is easy for you. Next one is Jaya Kriya. What we do, this is the last Kriya, last practice of the Gayatri Kriya. You inhale up and you exhale down. So what is happening here, when you inhale, that's the maximum air you can take in. You can maximum inhale. When you exhaling, you squeeze the thumb and you exhaling until your pelvis, not just halfway. If you exhale until pelvis, so there is more space for inhalation, more oxygenated. One thing, this kriya also really help to lymph nodes. Lymph nodes is the lazy limbs. You have to active them to work. So this is really good when you're going back and forth, you're activating your lymph nodes, and lymph nodes is very simple, known to, is has been many research, is pretty well. First is improve your immune system and prevent the breast cancer. So that is the Jaya Kriya. Yes, definitely is increasing the immune system and your respiratory system. Jaya Kriya, let's start. Inhale, raise arms up, exhaling down. Last five, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale, raise your arms, big inhale and hold breath in. Eyes closed and just feel awakening your soul, awakening your willpower, awakening your immune system. Exhale, hand to your knees. Stay eyes closed, let go your breath. Feel your third eye, Ajna Chakra. It's working on your pineal gland. Improving your concentration, building the power of your intuitive. You're opening yourself in new dimension to recognize your true self is blissful, joyful, playful, expandable. Release your stress. Let's slowly lay down on your back, very briefly, Savasana, which is so good for releasing stress while you are working on computers and laptops. Let's stretch your legs. And with helping hands, lay down on your back. And we are doing briefly, Savasana. I am with the time little bit tight, so but I will take on very brief few more minutes to just do closing. Just relax your hands, slightly open your arms and legs in Savasana. Relax your face, relax your spine, relax. Relax your breathing, slow down your heart pumping. Slow down your heart pumping. Relax your breath, relax your face. Relax your glands. Relax. Relax your heart pumping. Relax your throat. Relax your lungs. More calm. Anando asmi. I am bliss. That's me. That's my true nature. That's my identity. Your identity is blissful, joyful, playful, expendable, loving, kind. That's your identity. Plus, slowly wiggle your toes and fingers, moving head side to side. Bring your knees to your chest, hold your knees with your arm, and rolling side to side. And then slowly rocking back and forth a few times, and then sit down into easy pose. Palms in Namaskar Mudra, eyes closed. Just feel calm and relax. We're going to repeat five times. Oh, that's really simple, very powerful to release your stress. Slowly exhale. Slowly inhale in your belly, in your chest, and chant Om together. Om. Inhale, second one. Last one, longer one, big inhale. Om Bahu Shanti Antariksagam Shanti Prathavi Shanti Rapa Shanti Roshadaya Shanti Vanaspataya Shanti Vishvedeva Shanti Brahma Shanti Sarvagam Shanti Shanti Reva Shanti Shama, Shanti Redhi. One Om, three Shanti together. Inhale. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Proud yourself. Grateful to all yogis, rishis, yogacharyas brought this wisdom to us. Grateful to your parents and teachers. Happy International Yoga Day to all of you.
Namaste.
And blessing to all of you. I would be happy to, if you have any question, anything you want to chat with me, I am here for you. How is everyone?
बहुत बढ़िया, बहुत आनंद रहा. और आपने पांच स्थूल तत्वों से अपनी बात शुरू की, उनके सामंजस्य से बात शुरू की, और चलते चलते आपने आनंद पर पहुंचकर बात समाप्त की, जो कि परमात्मा का स्वरूप है. आनंद कंद कहा जाता है ईश्वर को, आनंद स्वरूप परमात्मा कहा जाता है. तो स्थूल तत्वों से लेकर परमात्मा तक का सफर आज हमने आपके साथ किया. समय बहुत कम था और जो भी था उसका पता भी नहीं चला, लेकिन फिर भी वी वुड लाइक टू हैव एन इंटरैक्टिव सेशन एंड वी विल टेक फ्यू क्वेश्चंस. सो दोज हु विश टू आस्क अ क्वेश्चन, प्लीज वर्चुअली रेज योर हैंड एंड देन यू कैन आस्क योर क्वेश्चन. आई कैन सी गौतम सिंह. गौतम, प्लीज गो अहेड.
हाँ जी गौतम जी, अपने आप को म्यूट करिए और आपकी वीडियो भी नहीं चल रही है.
अरविंद सर, वन क्वेश्चन इज देयर इन द चैट फ्रॉम अनिमा.
अनिमा, अनिमा आप जब तक गौतम वापस आते हैं, अनिमा तब तक आप अपना क्वेश्चन पूछ लीजिए प्लीज.
यस प्लीज. अनिमा जी,
एक अनिमा जी ने एक क्वेश्चन यहाँ लिखा था. स्वामी जी, मैं आपसे वो सवाल मैं पूछ लेता हूँ. मुझे लगता है कि अनिमा जी बात कर नहीं पा रही. अनिमा जी ने कहा है, अनिमा जी लिखती हैं कि गुरु जी प्रणाम, मेरी मम्मी को नीज में पेन रहता है. 50 वर्ष, मेरी मम्मी को नीज में, घुटनों में दर्द रहता है. 50 वर्ष से अधिक की आयु है और वेट भी ज्यादा है. उनके लिए कौन सा योगा योगाभ्यास सही रहेगा, ये उनका सवाल है.
तो अनिमा जी, आपका नाम बड़ा सुंदर है. तो ये अनिमा, लगीमा, ये जो है 7 सिद्धियां हैं, उनमें से एक आपका नाम है. अनिमा, गणिमा और ये 7 जो सिद्धियां हैं, उनमें से नाम आपका है, तो ये बड़ा अच्छा है. और दूसरा, आपकी माता जी को घुटनों में दर्द है, वजन भी ज़्यादा है. तो एक तो यही है कि सबसे पहले वजन हमें कम करना पड़ेगा. घुटनों के दर्द होने के कई बहुत सारे कारण होते हैं, एक कारण से नहीं होता. एक तो होता है कारण कि हम ओवर यूज कर रहे हैं हम अपने घुटने. हमारे जो घुटने हैं उनके आसपास के जो टिश्यूज और लीगामेंट्स है वो स्ट्रॉन्ग नहीं है, तो हम सिर्फ उनके कारण से वीक हो जाते हैं, वो फिर दर्द करने लगते हैं. या फिर वजन ज़्यादा होता है तो वो धीरे धीरे घुटने दर्द करने लगते हैं या जॉइंट्स दर्द करने लगते हैं. तीसरा कारण होता है सामान्यतः हमारा भोजन. जो हम भोजन कर रहे हैं शायद वो आपकी प्रकृति के अनुसार नहीं है. इसमें तीन वो होते हैं, तीन दोष होते हैं, वायु वायु कारक, पित्त कारक और कफ कारक. यदि हमारे पित्त कारक है या वायु कारक, अधिकतर जो है वायु कारक लोगों को जो है घुटनों में दर्द होता है, उनको चावल खट्टी चीज़ें ये शाम को नहीं खानी चाहिए. और रहा योगाभ्यास की बात, तो योग तो सारे ही करने चाहिए. और योग से आपके घुटने भी ठीक होंगे, आपके इम्यून सिस्टम भी ठीक होगा, नींद भी ठीक से आएगी. तो योग उसमें जो है जैसे एक चेयर पोज है, उत्कुट आसन उसको बोलते हैं, वो दीवार के सहारे आप कर सकते हैं प्रारंभ में, या साइकिलिंग कर सकते हैं लेट करके ज़मीन पर. तो हमें क्या करना है, जो हमारे जो लिगामेंट्स है घुटने के चारों तरफ उनको हमें स्ट्रॉन्ग करना है. एक दूसरा हमें ये हैबिट डालनी है, जब भी हम स्टेयर से चढ़ें या स्टेयर से नीचे उतरें, हम घुटनों का कम से कम यूज करके हमें अपनी जो थाई मसल्स हैं उनको यूज करनी है. क्या होता है कि घुटना जॉइंट्स को हम यूज करना शुरू कर देते हैं बहुत ज़्यादा, तो वो ऑलरेडी लिगामेंट्स वीक है और हमारी थाई मसल्स जो है वो उनको यूज नहीं करने उनको यदि हम यूज नहीं करते ठीक से, तो घुटनों का दर्द, उनका ओवर स्ट्रेस पड़ता है घुटनों पर. तो थाइज के लिए हमें चेयर पोज है, हमारी जो है वो लेट करके कमर के बल लेट करके साइकिलिंग करें तो वो बहुत अच्छा है. तो ये छोटी छोटी चीज़ें सभी करनी पड़ती है. थोड़ा सा भोजन ठीक कर लो, थोड़ा सा एक्सरसाइज कर लो, थोड़ा सा अपना वजन कर लो, वजन कम कर लो, तो ये सब साथ एक साथ चलता है. ऐसा नहीं कि बस एक्सरसाइज की तो हो गया, आपको भोजन भी थोड़ा ठीक करना पड़ेगा, आपको योगा भी थोड़ा ठीक करना पड़ेगा, आपको वजन भी थोड़ा ठीक कम करना पड़ेगा, तो तब ये सब चीजें ठीक हो जाएंगी.
स्वामी जी, मुकुल का प्रश्न है कि वजन कम करने का सर्वश्रेष्ठ तरीका क्या है?
देयर इज वेरी सिंपल सिस्टम, इनपुट एंड आउटपुट. इफ इज आउटपुट एनर्जी इज गोइंग लेस एंड इफ आई कीप इनपुटिंग एनर्जी इन, सो देन इज ऑटोमेटिकली वेट गोज इंक्रीज. मीन्स हम जो खा रहे हैं, जो हम भोजन इसको शरीर को दे रहे हैं, शायद वो हम जरूरत से ज्यादा दे रहे हैं, एक कारण. दूसरा, हम भोजन तो दे रहे हैं, एक्सरसाइज या उससे हम वर्क इतना नहीं ले रहे हैं. इनपुट एंड आउटपुट एनर्जी हैव टू बी बैलेंस्ड टू मैनेजमेंट. टू लूज बॉडी वेट इज नॉट ओनली जस्ट अबाउट फूड, इट इज टू मैनेज आवर mental stage. If you are mentally balanced, then body weight will be reduced. If you have sayam, atha yoga anusasanam, यदि आपके जीवन में अनुशासन है, डिसिप्लिन है, आपका भोजन ठीक है, आप सुबह ठीक समय से उठते हैं, आपकी थायराइड पैराथायराइड ग्लैंड ठीक से काम कर रही है, so then you can manage your body weight. So definitely yoga practice, please you do yoga practice every day. And that is help to balance your five elements. It help to balance your gland system. It help to improve your promise. It's called sankalp. जिन लोगों का वजन थोड़ा ज्यादा होता है वो संकल्प तो लेते हैं कि भाई आज से मैं अभ्यास करूंगा, आज से मैं अपना भोजन ठीक करूंगा, ये करूंगा, वो करूंगा, लेकिन मनोबल कमजोर होता है. तो योगाभ्यास यदि हम करते हैं, मनोबल जो है उससे स्ट्रॉन्ग हो जाता है और उसी से आपका वजन कम होगा. आप कितनी एक्सरसाइज कर लो, कुछ कर लो, भोजन ठीक कर लो, तो भी नहीं होगा जब तक आपका मनोबल जो है वो स्ट्रॉन्ग नहीं है, आपके मन पर संयम नहीं है, दुनिया की कोई ताकत नहीं वजन आपका कम कर रहे. तो आपका मनोबल कौन बढ़ाता है? योगाभ्यास. योगाभ्यास क्या करता है? आपका आत्मबल बढ़ता है. जब आत्मबल बढ़ता है आपका मनोबल बढ़ता है. मनोबल आप बढ़ने से आपके जीवन में संयम और अनुशासन आता है. ये चीज ध्यान से रखो. ये ऐसा नहीं कि योग से आपका वजन कम होता है, ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है. योग से आपका आत्मबल बढ़ता है. सीधी बात है, उल्टी उल्टी मत चलो. योग जो है एक विज्ञान है, आध्यात्मिक विज्ञान है. योग से आत्मबल बढ़ता है, आत्मबल से जो है मनोबल बढ़ता है, मनोबल से जीवन में संयम आता है. और संयम हो, आपका वजन भी कम ठीक होगा और आप जो है जीवन में सफल भी होंगे। जो आप लक्ष्य करोगे, जो आप लक्ष्य लेंगे, जो आप संकल्प करेंगे, सब सिद्ध होंगे। तो थोड़ा सा मनोबल बढ़ाओ और मनोबल आपका बढ़ेगा, डेली योगाभ्यास करो।
राइट, नाउ आई एम इनवाइटिंग वर्षा टू आस्क अ क्वेश्चन। आई कैन सी वर्षाज हैंड रेज। वर्षा प्लीज अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ एंड गो अहेड।
Can you hear me?
हाँ जी वर्षा जी, नमस्ते।
गुरु जी नमस्ते। मेरा सवाल ये है कि जब भी मैं टीका या चंदन या रोली कुछ भी लगाती हूँ तो मेरा पूरा जो माथा है उसमें दर्द होना शुरू हो जाता है। जब मैं मेडिटेट भी करती हूँ तो मेरा जो सेंटर पे जब मैं ध्यान लगाने की कोशिश करती हूँ तो मेरा पूरा जो आईब्रोज है उसमें भी पूरा दर्द होना शुरू हो जाता है। तो मैं ऐसा क्या करूं कि ये जो मतलब इससे मैं छुटकारा पा सकूं, जो ये दर्द होता है इसका क्या रीजन है?
पहला रीजन तो ये है, जो हम तिलक लगाते हैं तो वो उसका मुख्य कारण जो है, जो हमारा आज्ञा चक्र है उसको एक्टिवेट करना
जी।
एक्टिवेट होता है तभी जो है वो थर्ड आई और आपका इंट्यूशन, आपकी इंट्यूशन पावर भी अच्छी होगी। यदि इस तरह के ये सब लक्षण हो रहे हैं, आपको पहले अनुभव हो जाता होगा कि भाई कोई चीज़ हो रही है या होने वाली है उस तरह, तो वो इंट्यूटिव पावर उन लोगों की होती है जो थोड़े से बहुत सेंसिटिव होते हैं वातावरण से, विचारों से, भाव से। तो तिलक लगाने का उद्देश्य यही है कि हम अपनी ऊर्जा को केंद्रित करें। अब हम किस चीज़ का तिलक लगा रहे हैं, हम चंदन का लगा रहे हैं या किसी दूसरी चीज़ का लगा रहे हैं, तो आपके लिए मैं कहूँगा कि चंदन का तिलक आपके लिए बहुत उपयोगी होगा। दूसरा यह है कि एक ओम का उच्चारण करें 11 बार, दैट विल बी वेरी हेल्पफुल। थर्ड थिंग, सोने से पहले जो बादाम का तेल आता है उसको थोड़ा सा माथे पर जो है आप उसको मालिश करके सोएं, तो वो 2-4 दिन में ही ये सब चीज़ें ठीक हो जाएगी।
थैंक यू।
और ध्यान जरूर करो। ध्यान करने से जो है वो आपकी स्टेमिना बढ़ जाएगी, मतलब आपकी स्पिरिचुअल ऊर्जा तो ठीक है लेकिन हमारी जो न्यूरोलॉजिकल सिस्टम है वो थोड़ा सा वीक है। यदि आप थोड़ा ध्यान करो तो आपकी जो न्यूरोलॉजिकल सिस्टम आपका स्ट्रॉन्ग हो जाएगा, तो सिर का दर्द खत्म हो जाएगा।
जी,
चंदन का तिलक जरूर लगाओ है और बादाम रोगन का मालिश करो
जी।
2-4 दिन में ठीक हो जाएंगे, लेकिन ये अच्छी बात है, इसका मतलब आपका जो आध्यात्मिक ऊर्जा है वो एक्टिवेट है
जी।
स्वामी जी, एक प्रश्न सत्य नारायण जी से आया है। वो कहते हैं कि बीपी को कंट्रोल करने के लिए क्या करना चाहिए?
सत्य नारायण का भजन करो नाम इतना सुंदर है भाई बीपी किसका बढ़ता है? सत्य नारायण का तो नहीं बढ़ेगा उससे दूर हो जाएंगे तभी बढ़ेगा बीपी
वाह, अब ये बढ़िया बात। अब असल में
प्राणायाम से जुड़े रहो, और दूसरा बीपी कम करने के लिए एक चंद्र वेदी प्राणायाम है, वो सिंपल सा है। आप सीधे बैठ करके बाई नासिका से हमें श्वास को लेना है, दाहिना से हमें छोड़ना है। लेफ्ट से लिया हमने, राइट से छोड़ना है। बाई से लिया, दाएं से छोड़ा, बाई से लिया, दाएं से छोड़ा। एक तो ये बहुत अच्छा है, एक भ्रामरी प्राणायाम आपने सुना होगा, या जब हम श्वास गहरे लंबे श्वास लेकर के ऐसा करें, जिनको हाई ब्लड प्रेशर है, जिनके सिर में दर्द रहता है, जिनको नींद नहीं आती, भ्रामरी प्राणायाम रामबाण है उन लोगों के लिए। जिन लोगों के लिए स्ट्रेस क्रोनिक हो चुका है वो लेट करके भ्रामरी प्राणायाम करें 10-15 मिनट डेली। आप देखेंगे कि पहले दिन से ही आपके जीवन में परिवर्तन होना शुरू हो जाएगा। भ्रामरी प्राणायाम गजब है, मतलब उसके इतने सारे लाभ है कि आप मैं गिन भी नहीं सकता। एक भ्रामरी प्राणायाम जो है, जो हमारा इम्यून सिस्टम है उसको एक्टिवेट करने में बहुत लाभ करता है। नाइट्रिक ऑक्साइड जो है इसी से बनती है, ये एक्टिवेट कर देता है भ्रामरी प्राणायाम उससे। तो भ्रामरी प्राणायाम करोगे, चंद्रभेदी प्राणायाम करोगे, आपका हाई ब्लड प्रेशर सामान्य हो जाएगा। और सत्यनारायण का भजन करो, उनसे जुड़े रहो। आपका क्या, पड़ोसियों का भी नहीं आपका हाई ब्लड प्रेशर होगा यदि उनसे जुड़े हो। जी धन्यवाद सत्यनारायण जी।
एक स्वामी जी एक अंतिम प्रश्न के रूप में ले लेते हैं। ये हमारे अजय कुमार पूछते हैं कि अजय कुमार लिखते हैं कि गुड मॉर्निंग गुरुजी, सर माय बॉडी स्टार्ट्स शेकिंग और यू कैन से माय बॉडी कहीं आगे चले स्टार्ट शिवरिंग एज आई स्टार्ट डूइंग प्राणायाम स्पेशली व्हेन आई ट्राई टू डू स्टमक एक्सरसाइज और आई ट्राई टू बेंड माय बैक। सो आई वांट टू नो व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम बिहाइंड दिस। माय एज इज 28 एंड वेट इज 90। सो इन्हें आगे पीछे बेंड करने से शरीर कांपने लगता है, तो ये जानना चाहते हैं कि ये क्या समस्या है या जब वो ये अभ्यास करते हैं तो उसमें क्या गलती रह जाती है।
हाँ तो अजय जी इसमें दो तीन चीज़ें हैं, मैं शारीरिक बताऊंगा फिर जो है आध्यात्मिक बताऊंगा उसके क्या वो हो रहा है। फिजिकली व्हाट इज हैपन इफ इज योर बॉडी इज शेकिंग, इट मींस माय न्यूरोलॉजिकल सिस्टम इज वीकर, माय मसल्स आर लिटिल बिट वीकर, सो इट मींस आई एम पुटिंग एक्स्ट्रा स्ट्रेन ऑन देम एंड देन माय बॉडी इज स्टार्ट टू शेकिंग लिटिल बिट दैट। ऑन एनर्जेटिक लेवल I'm talking the because I don't know what type of the practice you are doing and what type of the background of your family where this physical bodies came. So from where your physical bodies came, that is very big role of the spirituality or anything in your life. So that's what is this called Pitru Puja and all of those things are there. I'm not talking these things here, but this is the very big role on your spirituality, big role in your material life, education of your ancestors. So sometime our lunar energies get weaker and then these symptoms comes, or sometime is kundalini energy is rising but there is a path is not enough strong, channels are not open, so then body that energy, kundalini energy, make you to shaking. That's very common happen when some people are sitting in the kirtan or going in temple or some energetic place, people have sensitive that energy is wakening up but channel is not open. Channel means Muladhara Chakra, Swadhisthana, Manipur, Ida, Pingala, Nadis, they are not properly communicating, so they feel blockage and then body start to feel little bit shaking. So I'm just telling from the physical to the spiritual, whatever could happen in the, you can relate to whatever it is for you. It does make sense to you, right, Ajay?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much, Swamiji. This was a wonderful session. Dear all, that wraps up our session. On behalf of ICFAI's Education School, the ICFAI University, Dehradun, I convey sincere gratitude to Yogarshi Vishwaketu and our Vice Chancellor, Dr. Mudu Vinay, for taking out time from their busy schedule and making this program with their glorious presence. I also thank my colleagues for making this event a success. And last but not the least, our head of the department, Dr. Meena Bhandari, Ms. Atulya Verma, Academic Coordinator, Ms. Swati Ratuvi, Faculty Associate, and Mr. Akhilesh for extending their constant support and guidance. So ladies and gentlemen, do stay safe and look after yourself. Thank you very much for joining to attend this session. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you, everyone. I'm grateful to be here with you guys. Thank you so much. Hari Om Tat Sat.
Hari Om Tat Sat. Swami Pranam.
Pranam Ji.